What is up? I missed filming for you guys, but this video is gonna be fun and jam-packed with a lot of stuff that's gonna be fun. So, yeah, you should get your popcorn and some soda because this video might be pretty long. But I'm gonna show you kind of like some DIY phone stuff, you know. Now, I have an Android, so I'm not sure if this is gonna work for iPhone, but I'm one of those people who use Android instead of iPhone. I know that's not very common, but yeah. But yeah, so I'm not sure if this all can apply. I mean, some of them might, but I'm not sure if all of them can apply to iPhones, but I'm going to be showing you on an Android. I'm sorry if you wanted to see an iPhone from me, but if you watch see what's on my phone, then you'll know I have an Android, which is right here. Yeah, it's going to be jam-packed. I mean, I was gonna put these in like their separate videos, but I was like, why not just do one whole thing where you describe or show some ways to like deck out your phone to make it your own, to make it like DIY phone stuff, if that makes any sense. So, you might want to get your popcorn because I have a feeling this video is gonna be at least 20 minutes long if you look in the running time. Or the time in the corner. I don't know that now because I'm actually filming it right now. So, yeah, but we'll see where it's at when I'm done. By the way, kids, the phone I have, in case you're wondering, is the LG... No, the Samsung. Wow, Tiffany. Samsung Galaxy Grand Prime. So, if you have that phone, you should comment below phone buddies or phone twins, whatever. But... yeah, so you should go watch my what's on my phone. That was like last year or something, but I can make another one if you want me to. Sure. But yeah. So this is going to include, you can change your font on your phone without root and stuff. So there is a way to do it, which I'm going to show you how to do that. And there's also, I'm going to show you how to do a ringtone. My notes are over there. And then maybe some wallpapers you could make for your phone, you know? Because I do that kind of stuff. And I will soon get some of those videos out on their own. But yeah, this intro is getting freaking long. So I'm going to let you guys watch the video. And yeah, I'm going to let you kind of enjoy the video. So yeah. You're waiting for it, aren't you? Right? Lego! Okay, sorry. So now for the font part of this video. I tried to film this before, but I kind of failed. So we're going to try this again. So, as you can see on my app names and my battery percentage and my clock, I have a different font. It's basically, first what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to get a font from like the website such as like Space Font or Font Space or whatever that it's called, or thefont.com, or any font downloading website that you know or use or whatever. And then you're going to want to download that. And then first the apps you're going to want to need also is a Fox Explorer, or like a Fox Explorer app, I guess, but I prefer this one, so I'm going to use this one. But if you can do the same exact things on that app, then use the app that you want to use, but I use that one. It's this blue folder app right here. And then you're also going to need High Font, which looks like that blue one right below the Google icon. So when you download your font, you're going to want to go and you're going to want to retrieve it. So you're going to go into your File Explorer and you're going to find it where your phone put it. So it's probably in your Downloads folder, which is right here. Now I have some here, but we're going to do it with, I guess, this sloppy hand one. So it's going to be a zip file. So you're going to want to click it and then hit the zip viewer. And then actually let's use DK Midnight Chalker. It's supposed to be like a TTF file, but I can find one that has that. How about the 4050 one, this one? Okay, or we use that one already. Well, Jack's, I think that's one I have on here. Hold on, I'll get this right. How about this one? So you're going to want to hold it down once. We're going to extract it first. And then you're going to want to go into the folder, its own folder.
And then you're going to want to hold it, hit more. You can do copy, move to, but put it in the folder. So you're going to put either copy or move to. I like move to, and you're going to want to put it in the high font folder. And move it there. Again, you know, do that. Okay, then you're going to want to go over to high font, which looks like this. And you're going to want to go and find that font. First, you can hit this and then my font. Custom font, scan. So it's going to scan for new font. And we did this one. So you're going to want to click it. And then like use or whatever thing it says, you know, apply or something along that line. Then it's going to bring you to an install page, so you're going to want to install that. Then done. Okay, it's going to do that, but if you want, you can go into your settings, your phone settings. Like this. And then you're going to go into your font settings, I guess. Which I have, lollipop. So then you go into like your settings, display, and then font. And then it should be in the list. It should say like my font in like parentheses. See? You're just going to want to click it. And then you can adjust it to how you want it to look. And then hit done. Or apply. And then it should change it. See? Isn't that cool? Yeah, so that's how you can change your font to whatever you want.
Okay, so the next thing that I'm going to show you is the ringtone part of this video. I was going to, again, just like I said before, make this into like its own video, but I kind of figure why not just make a whole video about like DIY phone stuff, because I thought that would be fun. So anyway, here is my desktop. I don't know where I found this photo from on my background, but it's probably on like Google somewhere or like Pre-Hardit or something like that. I don't know. But, yeah, so what you're gonna need is you can use whatever kind of software you want, but I'm using Audacity, which is free. You can use any type of like audio editor, basically, but I use Audacity, which is completely free. No, I'm not being sponsored by any of the programs that I'm using. I'm just using them, so. But if they wanna sponsor me, please do, but I'm not being sponsored. But yeah, so that's right here. And yours might look different because I think I changed the colors in my PC like to a blue color. But the background for you, I think, should be like gray if you haven't done anything. So don't worry about the blue. That's not going to damage anything. So, yeah. First, you're going to want an audio file. Now, how I like to do it, if my phone rings, you'll hear it. But I like to take things that people say, like maybe like a quote that they said, and then set that from my ringtone. So you can download that from like YouTube or whatever kind of audio that you want. I think I might have something, or you know, my computer will load. Okay, so see how I have like this right here? Link saying his wife's name? Yeah, I have that. If you don't know who Link is, it's Link Neal from Good Mythical Morning. So shout out to GMM. yeah, so we can, maybe I can go in and find like an audio file. Now this can work. You can trim a song if you want to make it like, your ringtone for when someone calls you. But I like to do them for like text tones and stuff. I mean, for calling ones as well, but I like to do it for text tones. So that's what we are going to do, I guess, if I can find a thing for that.
So I don't know if I have one, but we can use, I have this one. So I'm gonna remake that ringtone for you guys, I guess. First you're gonna wanna, you can go to YouTube and look up the video. Now this will help you for like where to clip it instead of listening to the whole thing again. So we're gonna do a DMM one here. So shout out to DMM. And this is how you're gonna know where it is in the thing. So we're gonna watch the video. Okay, so by the way, if you don't know, that's Link, by the way, in case you don't know who he is, but yeah. So you're gonna wanna download the audio basically, but this is so you know where it is to save you time when you actually do it, so you don't have to listen to it the whole time. So
yeah, the shifty elk. I wish I were a reindeer, but I'm an elk.
Yeah, yeah. But what does that mean? There's a gradient in there. Have you noticed that? None of the artistry is purposeful. Let's not go Bob Ross on this thing. The guy just put a orange, a green, and a red. This is a flag.
A flag of what?
A country, you dork.
Yeah, but what country is orange, green, and blue?
What country is really into elk?
So I want to have the ringtone have Link saying a country, you dork, because it's funny. So again, credit to GMM, but in case you don't know what GMM is, here's, like, you're seeing it now. But, yeah, so we're going to check the time code. So, if you see right here is the time code. We're going to watch that when he says it.
Flag of what? A country, you dork.
So, it's 5:44 right here. So, then you're going to take the audio, if you don't have it already, which I do, that's Link, by the way, in case you don't know who he is, but, yeah, then you're gonna wanna take the audio from that, which I have right here, you're gonna wanna drag that into your, audio, editor, which I am using Audacity, but you can use whatever you want, maybe Adobe or something has one, I'm not sure, but we are using Audacity, as I said before, so we're gonna wait for that to import. Now, to get this exact, see, this is your track up here, this blue thing right here. That's your waves, your audio waves, basically. So we can go to selection start, and it was 5:44. So you go 5, see how it moved? And then minutes, we're going to go 44. You can obviously zoom in, zoom out, whatever. I'm going to zoom in if my computer will actually work. and then you're going to play it, and then find where you want it. So we can have it the audio like this.
Country, you dork.
Okay, so you're gonna basically split the audio where you want it to start. Okay, so you do whatever you want, but I'm just gonna hit S on my keyboard, which splits it. And then since this is where it starts, where we want it to start, I'm gonna delete this. So then you hit delete on your keyboard. Okay, and then you're gonna go back to that, and then you're gonna clip it to where it ends. So keep playing it and watch the. And then you're gonna watch the cursor go.
Country, you dork.
Yeah. So ends about maybe here. I'm like pointing to my screen, but you can't see it. But yeah. But can I move this? Okay, so we're gonna move this. Hit S. Now I'm gonna play that.
Country, you dork.
Yeah, but what?
Okay, so that's what we want it to be. So then what you're gonna do, you're gonna delete what's after it as well. So we just have that part of the audio. So we just have this bit of audio.
Country, you dork. Country, you dork.
Why? I don't know why my computer's doing that. But let's say we want that. You're gonna save that. And then you get it on your phone somehow, either via USB cord or email it to yourself. But I already have that ringtone,
So I'm going to use that, but I'm going to get it on my phone, and then I'm going to switch you to my phone, and I'm going to show you guys how to apply that to your phone.
Okay, so I just sent myself the ringtone. So now I'm going to show you how to set it. So I'm going to go into like a file explorer, which I have the ES one right here, which is like my favorite one because it works for everything. And by the way, I'm probably going to do a like hacks that you can do with that app. So stay tuned for that. But yeah, you're going to want to go into it. And then you're going to want to go to where your phone saved it, which if you've downloaded it, well, I need to go download it first. Okay, so this is my download folder that I have on my phone. As you can see, it's this record looking thing over here. So you're going to want to hold on to that. And it depends on what you want to set this for. If you want to set it for like your ringtone for like your text messages or something, you're going to put it in your notification folder. Which if your phone doesn't have one or you can't find it, then you can always make one, which is what I always do. Just, you know, make a new folder. And it will then pick it up. So then you're going to want to copy that. And then you're going to want to highlight that. And then go to move to or copy to. Or just, you know, at least put it there like I said before. And you're going to want to put it in your notifications. You're going to want to hit OK. Well, that's where I want it. So it depends on what you want to. Want to set it for. Then you're going to go back into your settings like so, and you're going to go into your where you change your set your ringtones, and you're going to want to go change it, and as you see it is there when you hit it.
Country, you dork.
And then whenever you get like a notification, if you set it for that, then that's what your phone will do. And that's how kind of I get my DIY ringtones from, you know? But I actually had it as this.
Christy.
That's what I had it as. So, yeah, it's pretty cool.
Okay, now on to the wallpaper part of the video. I'm gonna show you guys two wallpapers that it could be for your lock screen maybe, but yes, I will do more of these on their own, but I decided instead of doing just two things, I'm going to show you guys three ways to DIY up your phone. So yeah, again, you don't have to use the programs that I use. I just show you with those programs, but if you want to use them, you can. Or just basically, if you want to do this, then just do the method that works for that program, but the same thing. So yeah, excuse me. And if you know, if you've seen any of my DIY wallpapers or something, that I use a program called GIMP, which is basically Photoshop but free, and I'm not being sponsored, but if the GIMP people want to sponsor me, that would be amazing. So yeah, I did a video about like light blue and gold wallpapers. You should go check that video out. I think those came out really well or really good, so go check that out if you have not already. I suggest you do, because they came out really cool. Now, I don't have much art skills, so these won't be that, like, and they look really good. So I mean, a complete my artist can do this. But what you want to do is go into GIMP or a Photoshop program or whatever you want, but I'm going to be using GIMP. So again, you don't have to use programs that I use, but I just like to use them. So if you're going to use GIMP, you can follow exactly what I do, but yeah. So, okay. So to save us time, you can either, you know, make a new document the size of your screen, but I'm going to, since I think I have a template, a light blue template here, we're going to be using that. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to drag it into GIMP. This is going to be my
like background basically. Now these are basically gonna be like, this one I'm gonna show you is gonna say don't touch my phone basically. So basically we're gonna just do, well, first what you're gonna need is of course this, your text tool, and a gold thing, which I think I have. Let me go find it. Right here, so you can drag this in. I'm just gonna drag it in just in case we like need it or whatever. Well, we are, but yeah. So now what we're gonna do is basically we can hide that. I'm going to put some text in here that is gonna say, don't touch my phone. Okay, then you're gonna want to go into the text options and put around with it, put it how you want it. And you know me, guys, you know, fiddle around with it, you know, do what you want with it. But yeah, then you're gonna obviously fix the font, which I'm gonna do. This font. So yeah, you can move it to the middle. Probably not the middle, but anyway. Okay, so we have it in the middle. Now we're going to put horizontal gold. Well, it don't matter which order you do it in, but we can make the font gold first if you want. So you're going to want to take your gold and you're going to want to make it the size of your text. Make it, oh, cover the text basically like this. But put it underneath it, right? And you're going to want to take your text, right click, alpha to selection. So it selects all of the text. Now you can do this in whatever order that you want. But the main thing is, I'm sorry, that was my phone. To make sure the layer that you want this done to, is basically what is, you know, sectioned off there. Whatever, then you're gonna wanna go to select, invert, and then delete. And stuff that planet, and there's your gold text, which that's not how big I wanted it, but you know, we can. I'm gonna leave it for now, but you get my point. But anyway, okay, so now we have that. I'm gonna put the bars in, then that's when you can go online, you can, you know, make it, but you're gonna need a black bar or a bar like this. Okay, so you're gonna want to drag that in, and then you're gonna want to put them. Of course, you can obviously take out the white part. I'm sorry if this is really confusing, but yeah, I know we can do this without explaining it, but yeah. Then you're gonna want to put them all the way down the thing. Yeah, we're gonna make this fit the canvas. You know, like that. Then you're gonna copy them down the thing. So we're gonna create duplicate layers. So we're gonna take them and you're going to drag them down. So yeah. Okay, so now that we have them all out there like that. We can now combine them so they're all one layer, so it's easier. So we're gonna undo all of this, and then we can go ahead and do this. Merge visible layers. That's how it's now all one layer. Okay. Okay. We can just do that if you want. Then you're gonna take that gold photo again. I'm sorry guys, this is really confusing, but just try to follow along here. I'm gonna wanna make that fit like we did for the text. Like so. Like that. Then you're gonna do the same thing. You're gonna do alpha to selection. Then do this. You know, go to that layer that you want it done to. And then invert it. And then hit your delete button. And then you will have what you need. So you can do that. And then we can do that. Or we can do that. So now we have that, we can take this and we can move this, right? So now that we don't want it like that, we can erase it around it, which you can just do the selection tool. Select the stuff around it like this. Do on that layer, delete, and there you go. I'm sorry this was really confusing, but yeah, you get my point. You can just like delete the rows that are on the font or the text, whatever, and then there you go. I'm sorry this wasn't that great, but you get my general idea. So yeah.
So I hope that was helpful. I'm not sure if you can do this stuff for an iPhone, but I use an Android. I personally think that Androids are more flexible, I guess. I mean, iPhones are great in their own way, but I think Androids, you can do more with instead of, like, you know, because iPhones, you kind of have to be jailbroken to make a keyboard or something. I'm not sure. I don't have an iPhone. I don't know, like, iOS 10 or anything, but, yeah. So, comment something about the video. I don't know, but, yeah, I just don't want to shut up, but I will eventually. But, yeah. I'm pretty sure this video was pretty fun, because I think it is. I mean, I probably have fun filming it, but, yeah. So, I guess I'm going to shut up and let you guys either watch any of my other content, oh, wink, wink, and, or someone else's content. I don't know. But, yeah, but I suggest you watch my other content, because, yeah. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, because I worked on it, and, yeah, hope you, I don't know why I'm being like this, but anyway, basically, hope you enjoyed the video, and I will talk to you guys in my next video.